In 2012, America's on-again, off-again love affair with Formula One finally seemed to settle down with the completion of this wonderful racing facility here in Texas. Since then, we've been treated to some incredible races, including, of course, that classic wet-dry championship decider of 2015. It's the Circuit of the Americas then, situated 14 miles outside the great city of Austin. This is the 3.6-mile lap with 20 corners, 10 each to the left and to the right, and top speeds of around 200 miles per hour. Overtaking opportunities are available into turns 1 and 12, especially with that rear wing DRS wide open. With me today is Anthony Davidson, a man who knows this circuit quite well. Why do you think, though, Ants, that this Grand Prix has now found such huge success since returning to the calendar in 2012?
Well, full credit to the race promoters. They have a Grand Prix in a part of the country famed for its love of motorsport, and they do a fantastic job of advertising it to the right crowd, and then satisfying them when they're here with excellent facilities. It also tends to help when the circuit itself is good, and that's definitely true here. The layout is interesting and it produces some exciting action. Hosting a thrilling title decider like we had in 2015 wouldn't hurt either, so the pressure's on then to maintain that kind of quality here today.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. It's McLaren in pole position then, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Alonso, Esteban Ocon, and Perez, Ricciardo, Hülkenberg, Hamilton, and Carlos Sainz, Ericsson, Leclerc, Max Verstappen. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Bottas, Gasly, Magnussen, Romain Grosjean, and Sergei Sorokin. Hartley and Lance Stroll rounds off the grid.
Okay, you can brake late into one because of the incline. It's a slow corner though, so make sure you stay out of trouble. Good luck.
Zdravím vás, jsem F261 a dneska vás vítám u 18. závodu páté sezóny mé kariéry v F1 2018. Kde startuji z pole position na okruhu časem.
Thank you.
Window, you'll be on the super softs. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Pitting this lap then, come into the pits at the end of this lap. Vettel's taken the lead. Stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Thank you.
is 1.7 seconds. Super soft tire, that's the super soft on the car ahead. Some information on Verstappen. They seem to have an issue. We advise moving to mix 2. Fuel to mix 2. Virtual safety car, virtual safety car. Reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta.
Pojďme se podívat, co se mu stalo. Myslíš, že to je Esteban Ocon? Jo, tý můj kolega Ricciardo. A tady, kontakt Ricciardo Ocon.
Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we'll risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Thank you. distance to the leader is 6.7 seconds. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Gap to car in front is 4.7 seconds.
Tak brácha přišel.
Is 7.0 seconds. Laps of fuel remaining.
Thank you.
tyre data is looking positive so far. We think there's plenty of life left in these for the moment. The gap to the leader is 14.1 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. Our gap to the car in front is 12.6 seconds.
Sergio Pérez odstupuje v poslední kole. A ještě někdo do něj tady vrazil. To je Charles Leclerc. Ty vole, ale toho mě nechápu. On se mu mohl vyhnout, takže... No, já bych si doleva, tohle to je... V dané formule 1 by se mu vyhnul, tohle to je jenom zase bug hry.
That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
So, another fantastic victory for McLaren today. And Anthony Davidson, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres. But at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else. And that's exactly what they had today.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance.
Yeah. vítězů.
And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. It's a good result for Sebastian Vettel, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, he had a great drive today. Somewhat unexpected maybe, but I'm going to go for Kevin Magnussen. Quick, clean and in control. It was everything you could ask for.
After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us and goodbye until the next race.
On je dělat to na peníze. To pak nám vyberí Lance Stroll. A Lance Stroll neignoroval žluté vlajky. Takže já mám taky. Zakavorování, že si tím takovým zemitý. A přijde okola dál, že i světí byl opatrný. Stop and go. Bylo to vždycky takové připočteno. A je to nějaký výkonný pořadí. Už to si to mezi tomu budou rozdávat pouze, jestli se nadej. 20. do Kimi Räikkönen, 23 bodů od cílu. Fernando Alonso, přestože vyhrál, tak tím, že ten jeden půl ztrácí 80 bodů na Vettela. Za poslední tři závody se udělí bodů těchka 70. No a Pérez výpadek mě pomohl, aby se vytáhl právě na Sergio Pérez s rozdílem 3 bodů. A dále je to Pérez změny. Na té znací celý stavní kolem. Zatáčí Brandon Hartley stále bez jediného bodu. Pohár konfitéry. Tam ještě konfitéry drží. Dá se soutat u 7 bodů a nepřijde o něj. Už jsem si vzal titul pohár konfitéry.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. It wasn't the cleanest race today, was it?
Tohle to nechci komentovat. Nechci nikoho nasrat.
Do you think that you learned a lot from your rivalry?
Tohle to taky nechci komentovat, co jsi se naučil v rivalitě s Fernandem Alonzem.
Well, thanks anyway.
No a tady můžeme potvrdit, že jsem na jednu stranu prohrál rivalitu s Fernandem Alonzem po páté a vyhrál jsem rivalitu nad Danielem Ricciardem. Je ta bedna v pozici ukolza už na startu. Taky se splnil týmový cíl. 1171 bodů za závod, 2284 celkem. Tak už 8 tréninkových programů. Nic těžkého pro mě.
That's a great result. You did really well. I don't think we can have any complaints with that performance.
No a myslím si, že tohle by bylo z dnešního dílu prakticky všechno. Já děkuji, že jste se dívali a zatím na sedanou.